Hi, everybody. It's Dr. Sam Robbins. Now, if you've been listening to me for any length of time, you know that genetics aside, I am a firm believer that the way you look and feel is very dependent on your hormones. Unfortunately, there are many factors that can negatively affect your hormones, such as food, what you drink, you know, exercise, stress, supplements, and today's topic, seven things in your home that are lowering and actually killing your testosterone levels and at the same time increasing your negative anti-testosterone hormones. And this is a problem for both men and women, but much more so for men because they're more dependent on testosterone. Basically, with all these testosterone killers in your home, the end result is that you look and feel older. You're going to slowly lose your sex drive, lose muscle size and strength, get fatter, feel depressed, increase your risk for various cancers and diseases, and basically accelerate the aging process. And it seems that a primary cause of these problems is actually excess estrogen, which indirectly lowers testosterone. Also, estrogen is a primary cause of both breast and prostate cancer. So it's a big problem that you want to fix, obviously. Now, your body can create its own estrogen internally, which is called endogenously. However, there's also environmental estrogens from the outside, exogenously, and that's what I'm going to quickly discuss today because these you can control. Thus, you should try your best to limit or hopefully eliminate the following seven testosterone killers in your home. So the first is bisphenol A, also known as BPA. It's probably the most well-known of a family of chemicals used in the production of polycarbonate plastics for its effect of the hardness of plastic. Not only has it been linked to low testosterone, it's also been linked to erectile dysfunction, cancers for both prostate and breast cancer. And it's typically found in reusable plastic bottles, kids' sippy cups, the hard ones, clear, hard plastic items, and also the lining of food cans. The next one is parabens, another large family of chemicals which have a weak affinity for the estrogen receptors. And they're most present in sun-blocking, SPF-blocking lotions, although, and it's also that they have the potential to cause more damage because you'll apply these sun-blocking lotions all over your body. And this is not only, obviously, a very large surface, but your skin also absorbs chemicals quickly. So if you're out in the sun, please have a gradual exposure or use to a paraben-free lotion. And you will find these in a wide variety of products in your medicine cabinet, also found in, you know, cosmetics, shampoos, toothpaste also, and also shaving creams. The next one is called phthalates, and many air fresheners, you know, scented candles, but also other items with a mysterious ingredient called perfume are actually phthalates, and it's a compound used to make plastics more flexible. And you can find them in many cosmetics and actually personal care items as well, but make sure you stay away from them. Now, they're found in, you know, non-organic, non-essential oils, based scented candles, you know, even those body sprays, most commercial perfumes, air fresheners, scented bathroom sprays, aromatic personal care products. And they've also been found in a lot of fast food items, unfortunately. So the first three that I've mentioned, these are external xenoestrogens, and they're also food-based ones that would be internal, and the two worst are soy and beer. Again, soy, this is a main food source for massive amounts of phytoestrogens. Many vegans and vegetarians want to compensate the lack of protein from animal sources by eating more soy, which leads to a host of health problems. One of the worst, in my opinion, being also decreased levels in thyroid, in addition to the decreased level of testosterone. But suffice to say that irregular consumption of soy, even large dose of fermented sources, can have detrimental effects on your testosterone levels. And soy is most commonly found in, you know, meat substitutes, soy protein powders, miso, soy cheese, soy mayonnaise, and soy milk, soy sauce, soy yogurt, basically soy types of protein, and also tofu. And then we have beer. Now, the hops found in beer is actually a rich source of phytoestrogens, and even beer on the weekends does decrease your testosterone levels. So regular drinking or even large amounts have effects on your androgen levels, and they're compounded by just other health hazards of alcohol. Now, there's two other chemicals, and the next one is a big one that I've actually had in my house, and that's Triclosan. And this is the main antibacterial agent found in antibacterial soap. It and its cousin, triclocarbon, have a testosterone-lowering effect by decreasing the biosynthesis of testosterone. In fact, it's also carcinogenic, cancer-causing. And in fact, it's so bad that the European Union has banned this chemical in 2010. In fact, so has the state of Minnesota, but not the other 49 states in the United States. And it's also been noted that they do a poor job of actually killing bacteria and are partly to blame for the development of new strains of bacteria that are even more resistant. And you can find it in almost anything that has antibacterial things on there, such as antibacterial soaps and shampoos, skin cleansing wipes, toothpaste, if you can believe it, deodorants, shaving gels, children's toys, brake fluids, and antibacterial socks and even clothing. And then finally, we have benzophenones. Now, these are type of chemicals that are found most often in sunscreen lotions. Again, something I've told people to avoid even 20 years ago, but that's another topic. Not only do these chemicals lower your testosterone, they also decrease androgen receptor sensitivity. So that's a double whammy. Oh, and it also happens to lower thyroid production as well. So not only are you now losing muscle because of the lower testosterone, you're also getting fatter at the same time. And speaking of getting fatter, these chemicals also increase estrogen levels in men. So again, the sunscreen has a lot of negative effects. Now, I gave you a short list, all right, because there's a lot of other chemicals in your home that are actually killing your testosterone levels while also increasing negative estrogen levels. I just want to list some of the most common and potent ones. And there's, again, also environmental ones such as herbicides, pesticides, insecticides, but I'll discuss that on another day. Now, the solution here is that you should just maybe rewatch this video and take notes and go through your home and eliminate some of these products and ingredients. Like I said, there are more, but this is a really good start. Try your best to eat natural, organically grown foods and we're not dealing with any of the herbicides and pesticides. Then you'll also want to reverse the damage done by all this by stimulating your body to produce more testosterone again while reducing and eliminating the excess estrogen levels in addition to other testosterone-killing hormones. And for that, I suggest you click the link below in the description area and discover a proven formula that's actually can help naturally boost your testosterone levels, which will then increase your libido and muscle size. And let me know what questions and suggestions you have, and just let me know, leave your comments below. And as always, thanks for listening and have a happy and healthy day.